Coach B, teachers out there in the real world. Today, I just want to show you real quick what I have for field day. This is the HOPE official. Everybody starts wanting to change it, but as of right now, it's the official assignment sheet here for field day of this year, which you guys I know is going to be Thursday, starts at 8:30. Please be on time. But if you'll look on this field day assignment sheet, there are 12 stations right here where it says 6 and 7. These are concessions. Every station is on a 15-minute time slot. You can look on the next page and you'll also see that as well. It'll show the actual time slots. But every game is on 15 minutes. And that's why I did the concessions on 6 and 7. And you see it says concessions. It says buy it and then eat and rest. So you'll have, you know, other than Hampton right here, where is it right now? She's the only one by herself. Everybody else is paired up just the way it worked out by numbers. But you'll have, you know, roughly 40 kids-ish, probably 45 to 48 on some. I'm sure we're having two classes together. But it'll give you 15 minutes here in session six, or excuse me, station six is concessions. It'll give you about 15 minutes to buy your stuff. And all the kids go through so it won't be rushed. And then you'll basically stay in the same spot, which is in the lunchroom, and give you 15 more minutes to let them consume it. That way they'll be able to put their stuff in the trash in the trash cans right there in the lunchroom or right outside the lunchroom, and then they'll be able to go to the next station, which is going to be in the gym, dodgeball. So that would be, in my case, in my opinion, pretty easy. Now, you know, I don't really care the way. You can do it, you know, you can stay in the lunchroom, the AC, somebody will stay in the lunchroom, somebody go right there where the little buses are. Where the buses, you know, pick up the kids and sit there and watch, they're more than welcome to. That's up to you guys how you want to handle that. But again, that's why 6 and 7 is together, to give you a solid 30 minutes there of rest. Some of you teachers, and I'm sure the students, would like to be able to sit down and cool off a minute, get some drinks and so forth. But moving along, it's over here. You see that after the 12th station, or there's 12 stations again, but you see where it says lunch and cool down time, 11:45. So everything should be over at 11:45. Lunch starts at 1, and I'll talk about that here in just a few minutes. Let's just skip on. I'll elaborate, rather. And then right underneath it, dodgeball. And it says, see next page. Now, if you guys remember from last couple years, we've done kickball outside on the playground, and which the kids, you know, the kids who get to participate really love that. I know you guys who are sitting around watching that hot sun. It's supposed to be, I think, 92 degrees Thursday. Probably don't enjoy it as much, but I know it's a little hard to monitor the kids. They want to go on the playground, move around. It's a little bit difficult, so I want to try something a little bit different this year. We're going to do dodgeball in the gym. It'll be on a rotation basis, so don't wig out. I haven't got there yet. Don't you know, give me an email before you had a chance to hear this whole thing, but I think this will be pretty neat. So nevertheless, so lunch starts at 11:45 at 1, which that's primarily third grade. Again, I'll explain that in a second. Then you got dodgeball, and it starts a rotation. So before we talk about the lunch and dodgeball, let's move on down here. I told you a little bit earlier about the scheduling events. The first one starts at 8:30. The first station starts at 8:30 for everybody, and then it ends at 11:45. They're on 15-minute time slots. You know, I know some games out here, it may be a little bit too short. Some of them may be a little bit too long. I mean, I've been messing with this for the last few years, and I always think I need 20 minutes, and 20 minutes always seems to be too long. So we're going to try 15 minutes and see what happens. I can't go too long, because the longer these station times are, the longer this time right here, this 11:45 time, becomes a problem. It eats up to the day. And I want to give you plenty of time for the kids to change clothes. They will be wet. You make sure you remind the kids to bring something to change into. And they have to, want to be eat lunch and rest a little bit before we start, phase two of this thing. So, all right, now, again, coming back down here, we're talking about the 11:45 end time of the morning portion of field day. You can change clothes, lunch, and rest. Battle ball starts at 1. It says see below for schedule. So here we go, 11:45, field day. I guess I should have put part 1 is over, but nevertheless, we call it over. And it's 11:45 to 1, change clothes, lunch, and rest. Now, at 1 o'clock, I have third grade going into battle ball with teachers. So, last year we did the kickball with the teachers. This year, I talked to a few teachers, and they thought it might be a good idea to try to do the battle ball or do something inside. And we thought we'd do it on a grade level basis. It'd be a little more flexible for the teachers. But so at 1 o'clock, third grade reports to the gym. They can go ahead and, we'll play battle ball with them for about 30 minutes. Now after the third grade leaves, which would be 1:30, the concessions are still in the lunchroom. They're open all day. So I would encourage you to let the kids after battle ball go into the lunchroom, get them something, and then, of course, carry it back to the class if you're watching a movie or out playground, whatever you want to do. As a matter of fact, it says right here below, I get to this part, which is, I think, fairly important. It says if you're not playing battle ball, which, if you're a fourth or fifth grade, third's in the gym, fourth and fifth grade's not, you have a lot of flexibility here. And I put it right here, I said you will have the flexibility with your students to stay in the classroom and watch a movie or go on the playground. Let them go to the concessions area in the lunchroom or do whatever you like, because, flexibility is king. So if third grade is in there playing battle ball, and fourth, you want to come down and get concessions and let the kids buy some things, go outside in the playground for 15 or so minutes and play, or you go back to your classroom, it does not really matter to me. If you got a movie going on, you might want to hit pause, come back down, get them something, go back to your classroom. It's just whatever. It's whatever that's going to work good for you and make this a little bit more enjoyable for you. So, here's some important points right here I want to go over. Important point one, it says if possible, please try to let third grade get their lunch first, as they will be playing dodgeball at the 1:30 time slot. So, everybody's going to be over with at 11:45, wet, dirty, tired, hot, sweaty, the whole nine. So, I know a lot of you go back to your classrooms, let the kids change, stuff like that. Third grade, try to get down there as soon as you can. And if you do see if you're a fourth grade or fifth grade teacher and you see a third grade class coming, please, if it's okay, let them go in front. It's just going to be a sack lunch to take but a second, let them get their stuff. That way they can go ahead and go down to the classroom or where they're going to eat lunch, and they'll have a little more time before the battle ball starts. Again, the second thing, I've already actually mentioned this. It says concessions area in the lunchroom will be open morning and after lunch for your students. Plenty of time after lunch for them to go back and purchase some goodies. We've already sort of discussed that. So, again, that's the flexibility part. So that's pretty much it. I do have to show you this. This is the list of activities of station. This is the map of the field day events. You can see that the tug of war is the same as it always has for the last several years. It goes in order 1, 2, 3. We're doing the 40-yard dash this year. That should be interesting. Let's pray for that one. And you got the 5, and then here's the 6 and 7 in the lunchroom. So you could be able to, 7 could be outside right here in this bus line area. If they want to sit and watch the human trees or the team relay games or whatever, they're more than welcome to. That, again, that's on you. You may have half your class in, half your class out, just whatever. And then after you go to concessions, you'll go to the dodgeball, which is in the gym. And then right outside will be the blow-up water slide. Now, I do ask this one thing. After you do the water slide here, the sliding down thing, to go out the back, we have the rainbow station right out here where the dumpsters are and the buses park right out here. You're going to be soaking wet. The kids are going to be dirty. I really wouldn't rather you guys tracking that stuff back in the hallways and into the gym, especially the gym, because I don't have kids in there playing, and the floor is wet on there, and that gym floor is like playing on banana peels. So if you could, please help me out and go around the back. We'll try to have that gate open. If there's not, the kids can squeeze right through to go right there to the thing. So it's very simple. So anyway, again, here's all the where the activities are. I hope you can figure this out. It should make a little bit of a sense. Here are the list of the activities. There are 12, including 2 concession stations. So everything should make sense, I hope. If it does not make sense, I didn't do it. If it makes a whole lot of sense, I'm fully responsible for it. Isn't that how it works? I guess so, right? So real quick, I don't see anything else. Again, this again shows who you're paired up with. Just be at that station. I would probably encourage you to start walking out there, preferably be walking out there around 8:25, start moving, because at 8:30, I really need to start on time. I hope everything's set up by then and the kids are ready to go. So, because that 15 minutes, you know, every station is going to be very important that we stay on task the whole time. So, but anyway, here it is. I think you can pretty much figure it out. It hopefully makes sense. Just remember, again, the end this year, we're not doing kickball. We're doing battle ball inside. And you do have your designated time to be to the gym. Other than that, if you go outside and playground it, movie playground, any combination you want to do, it should be more enjoyable. It should, you know, having the flexibility with your kids should be more enjoyable. So I guess we'll find that out and see. But if you have any questions or anything at all, just give me a yell, email me, or stop me in the hall and say I did something wrong. And if I did something wrong, we'll either fix it. If it can't be fixed, I guess we have to live with it being something wrong. But anyway, guys, I appreciate you looking at this video and watching it. And I'll see you Thursday at 8:30. See you later. Out of here.